puff of breath, will lift that bowl full of burned up palms into a gray blizzard. Light as they are, they cling to everything. One breath, and we are flowered with gray that doesn't brush away, but smears into everything it touches. This is life. We, light as a feather on the wind of time, here and gone with a breath, but impossible to rub away, smearing into the fabric of this world, determined not to vanish. This is Ash Wednesday, drifting into our eyes, running with our sweet, gritty, and real, and light as air. We are no good at it, no good at being us. Desperately clinging to the illusion that we are solid, heavy beings, strong as mountains. We fool ourselves well, surrounding our ashes with all trappings of power and control, smearing them into the granite of time determined. We are different until the rain comes and the wind laughs across the rocks and we go sailing. This is Lent, smearing our faces with ashes and puff and run and smear, and we'll wash away and stick to our fingers and refuse to stay put. This is Lent, the gentle reminder that to be but a breath, a puff, here one moment and gone the next, is not fearsome, but freeing. Well, good evening and welcome to the First Universalist Church, for it is Ash Wednesday as we begin to celebrate the Lent of the season. For tonight, we begin the journey of Jesus to the cross. The love that he has given to us will be shown in a most ever so glorious way. Please join with me. The bulletin has been provided for you this evening as we all say the gathering. Almighty and most merciful Father, we have erred and strayed from thy ways, lost like sheep. We have followed too much the devices and desires of our own hearts. We have offended against the holy laws. We have left undone those things which we ought not to have done. But thou, O Lord, have mercy upon us. Spare those who confess their faults. Restore, O those who are patient, according to thy promises declared unto mankind in Jesus Christ our Lord. And grant, O most merciful Father, that we may hereafter live a godly, righteous, and sober life, to the glory of thy holy name. Amen. Our first hymn, Abide With Me. Let us pray this evening. Almighty God, the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who desires nothing and not the death of sinners, but rather that they should turn from their wickedness and live, we beseech thee to grant us true repentance in thy Holy Spirit, that those things may please thee of which we do at this present and at the rest of our life, hereafter may be pure and holy, so that at the last we may come in thy eternal joy through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Be with us now, O Lord, in this time of silence, for the prayers that bring us to this moment of Ash Wednesday, the moment when Jesus begins the journey to the cross. Be with us now, O Lord. For in this season of Holy Lent, let us be reminded of Jesus in the wilderness, for his love has bonded us so great that we may give him our life. Let us now pray the prayer that Jesus has taught us all so well. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen. Our biblical text this evening comes from the book of Luke, chapter 4, verses 1 through 13. Hear these words. Jesus, full of the Holy Spirit, returned from the Jordan and was led by the Spirit in the wilderness, where for 40 days he was tempted by evil. He ate nothing at all during those days, and when they were over, he was famished. The evil said to him, "If you are the Son of God, command this stone to be a loaf of bread." Jesus answered him, "It is written, 'One does not live by bread alone.'" Then the evil led him up and showed him an instant all the kingdoms of the world. And the evil said to him, "To you I will give their glory and all this authority, for it has been given over me, and I give it to anyone I please. If you then will worship me, it will be all yours." Jesus answered him, "It is written, 'Worship the Lord your God and serve only him.'" Then the evil took him to Jerusalem and placed him on the pinnacle of the temple, saying to him, "If you are the Son of God, throw yourself down from here, for it is written, 'He will command his angels concerning you to protect you, and on their hands they will bear you up, so that you will not dash your foot against a stone.'
Jesus answered him, "It is said, do not put the Lord your God to the test. When the evil has finished every test, he departed from him until an appointed time." This is the word of the Lord for the people of God. Thanks be to God. Amen. Our message this evening is quite simply entitled Bountiful. It is all about mercy this evening, this Ash Wednesday. The kindness and generosity of God, our Savior, appeared in Jesus. By the sacrifice of our High Priest, our sins are lived out. By the proclamation of our appointed prophet through the church, the dispenser of his undeserved love, we come to faith and are transferred into the kingdom of light, where our risen King rules. And it's all about mercy. As Luther says, Christ mercifully sinks and sticks himself into the water as though he were an ordinary sinner. So when we go into the water, we may pull out us, him. We see in the account of Jesus' baptism that the heavens are mercifully torn open in Mark chapter 1, verse 10. And the Father speaks, Luther states, heaven which before was closed is opened by Christ's baptism, and a window and a door now stand open for us to see through. No longer is the barrier between God and us, since God himself descends at the Jordan. The Father lets his voice be heard. The Son sacrifices and sanctifies the baptism with his body, and the Holy Spirit descends in the form of a dove. In this life, we find sin, death, and misery. In baptism, we find God and Father, Son and Holy Spirit, God of mercy, life, love. And we find that mercifully, heaven is nothing but windows and doors. It's all about mercy, bountiful mercy. We can do none of this ourselves. As one of our theologians has said, the whole work of our Lord may be summed up in this. He founded upon earth the kingdom of heaven, the kingdom of God. But the kingdom of God is the community of men and of women, in which God is the absolute and awesome master. God is love, and therefore the kingdom of God is a kingdom of love, and the community of those who have been reconciled to God in Christ must hollow its whole life and conduct it by love. The whole duty of members of the kingdom of God is comprehended by our Lord in one word. Be ye therefore perfect, as your Father which is in heaven is perfect. And again, be ye therefore merciful, as your Father is also merciful. The righteousness of the kingdom of God, which our Lord enjoins upon his people, is nothing else than ordering their whole life in accordance with the law of love. We can do none of this ourselves. We cannot, by our own reason or strength, believe in Jesus, come to him or do anything good. But because of our merciful anointed prophet and our mercifully anointed priest, our mercifully anointed king, and his death on our behalf, we are free to be bountifully merciful. As Luther said, therefore, if we recognize the great and precious things which are given to us, as Paul says, our hearts will be filled by the Holy Spirit with the love in which makes us free, joyful, almighty workers and conquerors over all tribulations, servants of our neighbors, and yet lords of all. For those who do not recognize the gifts bestowed upon them through Christ, however, Christ has been born in vain. Just as our neighbor is in need and lacks that in which we abound, so we are where in need before God and lacked his mercy. Hence, as our heavenly Father has in Christ freely come to our aid, we also ought freely to help our neighbor through our body and its works. And each one should become, as it were, Christ to be another, that we may be Christ to one another, and Christ may be same in all, that is, that we may truly be Christian. We do have a road among us. It is ahead of us. We follow Jesus to Jerusalem, to the cross and the tomb. Our Lenten journey will again show us the kindness and generosity, the mercy of God. But the journey is wasted if we do not understand that we can live bountiful, merciful lives. As Luther said, be truly Christians. It is about mercy poured out for us so that we can be merciful. So tonight, we will do some anointing to ourselves. We will anoint our foreheads, or at least mark them with ashes. We are dust, and dust we shall return. We are sinners indeed, but we are also the blood children of God, a kingdom of priests, a holy and ever-loving nation, a people shown mercy so that we can be merciful. Let the ashes remind you of how far you need to go. Let your prophet, priest, and king lead you to be so bountifully merciful tonight. Dear God, bless the ashes that we are going to give here tonight, the ashes that you might be giving in your home tonight. For it is the love of God and the journey to the cross and the tomb and the everlasting life of God that you have given us to be bestowed this evening. Amen. From dust to dust, you shall return. Amen. Join with me in the response this evening. The Lord be with you and with thy Spirit. Let us pray, O Lord, show thy mercy upon us, and grant us thy salvation. O God, may clean our hearts within us, and take not thy Holy Spirit from us. Hear this closing song. All people that on earth do dwell. The ashes will be available at the church this Sunday, for it is in God's time. Let us have our benediction this evening. For we are not called to be granite, not called to hold up the world. We are not powers moving through the cosmos with heavy responsibility lit by the stars. We are gentle gray puffs of ash, born in a blaze of fire and light, here but a moment, and on to the next. When we stand helpless and empty-handed, then we are most human. And only then we can reach out and grasp the empty hands of another. This is Lent, and it is holy. Remember, you are dust, and rejoice. Amen.